constantly smiles on your faces, and it didn't like disturb what you were doing as well. Your skills were amazing, and your coordination and your synchronization, everything, it was brilliant. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great comment from Showbiz judges.
Freddie, have you ever set your balls on fire?
Not intentionally. What I really enjoyed was the real technical aspect to it. And I don't know what you're like, but if I get nervous, first thing that goes are my hands. Yeah. And like to be spinning a ball on your hands when you're a bit nervous. Yeah. You know, I just had to rub mine. But however, I loved it. And then the power move at the end, I didn't think that was possible. Two balls spinning on one finger, amazing. Well done, lads.
Yeah, well done. Rio, a lot of pressure on the guys, especially with Andrew and the power move. Under the spotlights, I mean, you've been there every weekend at Old Trafford. It must be tough. How does it feel?
I think that's what impressed me most about these guys. I think under the spotlight, in front of all the people at home, to do the technique that you've done and nail it the way you did, especially the last one up there, which is ridiculous. Two balls, I can't do one, let alone two. Spinning them was just amazing for me. I mean, jumping over the postbox, you could probably put a letter in the postbox and dunked it the way you've done it. Fantastic. I think you totally smashed it. And the music mix, it took me.
Yeah. Good comments from both Showbiz and our sporting judges. So,
will it be gold, silver or bronze for the street team?
Hey! You'll get to vote later on! Let the judges have their say. Come on, what do you think? Let's have a look. Gold! Well done! The street team! High five!
We really want to win this.
I'd give a couple of my toes for it. I'm definitely... I'm really up for it.
I've seen your toes. Just give them anyway.
Next up, putting a new spin on their sport, we've got some very flexible cheerleaders and some not-so-flexible veteran footballers. Don't know what I'm looking forward to the most.
No, I do.
Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to Let's Get Gold, where sports teams from across the nation put on their showbiz hats and take to the stage for performances that rewrite the rule book. Now, Una, we discovered that you've got a little bit of a sporting past.
Yeah, I was a competitive swimmer as a child.
Oh, there you go.
Look
at that. Those eyes are saying, I don't ever want to swim again.
No,
you were seriously a competitive swimmer.
Yeah, I was. I was All-Ireland champion when I was 9. I was quite young.
Wow, so good for you.
So I swam right up to the age, I kind of started when I was 4 years old and then right up to 14, but I actually quit because we didn't have the facilities. I come from a small town, and I think like a competition like this is fantastic, you know, to get the money to fund, you know, the clubs and to get better sporting facilities. I just think that's what this is all about as well.
Yeah, really, I mean, £100,000 makes a massive difference to any sports club across the country. Freddie, wait till you see this clip, we've got a view. I'm only joking. It's before midnight, we can't show any of that. So, on with the action. Next in the frame is a unique group of footballers who make up the Welsh veterans team. I didn't know things like that existed, did you, Rio?
No.
Oh, it's crazy. Thanks for that. It's the Golden Oldies.
You don't stop playing football because you get old.
You get old because you stop playing.
We have a combined age of 964. And most of that is round this table. My name is John, I'm 68, and I'm the manager of the Wales Veterans Football League.
If the ball comes to you there, play it.
We want to prove that playing football at 60 is not too old.
Fred, 62, and he's top-class goalkeeper.
Tony is 62, Paul is in his 60th year. And they can both still keep it up.
I've been married to John for 44 years. I suppose you could call me a wag, but without the money.
If we won, we would set up an over-70s league and extend the training and the coaching and all the facilities to that age group as well. And we want to encourage more of the Golden Oldies to stay active.
Our power move is a penalty shootout where five of our players try to hit five targets in the goal.
as you can see, it's not going very well. Are we going to give those young'uns a run for their money?
Yes!
Are we going to win?
Yes!
Well, they've got some guts to be still playing out there, Edge. I'll tell you what, they've got some guts because of all them pies they've eaten. But can they dazzle us under the bright lights? Here's hoping. It's the Golden Oldie! It went
pretty good.
Pretty good.
Pretty good.
It's hilarious that the only head you managed to knock off was Rio's. But I tell you what, fellas, fair play to you because at your age, you know what? It's a phenomenal achievement.
You reckon so,
well,
dear?
Definitely.
Yes.
Definitely. You must be so pleased that the fellas can put out a performance like that.
Absolutely fantastic.
Yeah. Brilliant. All right, let's go to the main man, Rio. Come on, what do you think?
Unbelievable. I mean, an inspiration to myself to see guys of your age still playing football, still got the energy, the desire to go out there and play. I mean, it's phenomenal. So, I mean, Freddie retired at 34. He must be embarrassed.
Freddie, what do you reckon?
Yeah. Think of when I was watching that was, I hope there's a St John's ambulance outside.
Yeah,
we should be going through it. It's like the dad's army of football. I was expecting Ryan Giggs to pop out. But it was unbelievable. The reason we all play sport in the first place is because we enjoy it. You know, you might not have hit your targets, but everyone was smiling and everyone enjoyed it. So for that, I thought it was bob on.
Right, Martine, what do you think from a showbiz perspective?
It's just brilliant to watch you just really enjoying yourselves up there. That really is contagious, I think.
Yeah.
I loved the little goal celebration when you got the bad bag
right, yeah.
leaning over. I thought that was really lovely. And you gave Rio a run for his money. That. Who'd have thought?
He can come train you with us if he wants to.
I might not get in your team.
Una, what do you think?
I think for the entertainment value, thumbs up, definitely.
And really inspirational.
Yeah, definitely. You know, you're never too old. You know, I think that if I'm still in the Saturdays when I'm 60 and in my coloured tights on stage, I'll be a happy woman, you know, so well done.
I think you'll be called the Midweek Wednesdays by then. You've been an absolute inspiration, like the ladies said, but let's see what the judges have awarded you. So, judges, showbiz and sport, what do you think? Is it gold, silver or bronze for the Golden Oldies? Oh! Interesting! The showbiz ladies gave you gold, so therefore your performance as a whole was top-notch.
Yeah.
However, our sporting generals over there gave you silver, so from a sporting perspective, they're impressed,
no.
Not overly impressed. But well done, congratulations. Remember, that's just their opinion, because it's not about them. It's the studio audience who's going to decide whether you're going to make it into Saturday's final. So good luck, congratulations. Give a big round of applause, everyone, the Golden Oldies! There you go. Well done.
We'd love to hit more targets, but it happens to all of us. When it comes to the crunch,
yes.
Right, things can go wrong.
Our final team tonight are a 20-strong cheerleading squad, all hoping to win gold and prove that what they do actually is a sport in its own right. Just please don't mention pom-poms. It's the Sussex Tornadoes!
There's much more to cheerleading than pom-poms.
We're gymnasts, we're artists, but above all, we're athletes.
Me and Leanne have been running the Sussex Tornadoes for 15 years. We've known each other since school.
We're now a registered charity, which means that there's somewhere in the community for all the kids to go.
When I was younger, I was going down the wrong path, doing stupid things and just being destructive. And then I got asked to do cheerleading, so I thought I'd come down and give it a go. And I believe it's changed my life.
Being with the Sussex Tornadoes, I've met loads and loads of new friends. They're like my sisters.
We're friends because we're doing what we love. It makes us a stronger team.
I'm surrounded by lots of beautiful women all day long. They're not here today, but they are.
We want to win so that we can make our training facilities the best they can be. Our current floor we train on is horrendous. It sounds basic, but with a professional surface to train on, I know we can be champions.
For this show, we're going to push the boundaries to the limit. That wall book is going out the window.
Our power move is going to be done by Amy, and it's called the double back tuck basket.
I'm definitely terrified. I don't want to think about it not working out.
We want to show the nation what cheerleading really is, and we intend to get gold on the show tonight, right?
Yeah!
Going all out for a place in Saturday's final, give it up for the Sussex Tornadoes!
To the beach, each, let's go get a wave. They say what they gonna say. Have a drink, drink, found a boy's like bad bitches like me. It's hard to come by. The Patron, let's go get it down. The sound, yes, I'm in the zone. Is it two, three, leave a good tip. I'ma blow all of my money and don't give two.
I'm on the floor.
But I think you landed in Ben's chest.
It was pretty close.
It was pretty close. You hitting the floor. Do you get nervous when something like that happens with the power move?
Definitely. I've got to have trust in them, though.
We all thought it was great, didn't we, ladies and gentlemen? All right, well done. Let's go over to our showbiz judges. Una, what do you think?
Well, I thought it was fantastic, and it's so exciting to see cheerleading, because, you know, you're always associated with America, and it's so exciting to see that here in the UK. So I think, Ben, I'll ask you, do you reckon you might need some more boys on
Yeah, we need
squad?
A lot more boys.
Yeah, because he'll probably kill me for saying this, but my other half, he's Ben as well, Ben Foden, he plays rugby for England. He's probably going to kill me, but I think he would love to be kitted out, probably in one of those dresses and...
I'll be honest with you, and I think you should keep that to yourself.
Martine, what do you think?
The actual power that you see tonight is unbelievable, and it gave me goosebumps, and I just think you're so brave. I don't think you did quite get the double tuck basket as well as you should have. Did you think you did or not?
It went a little bit wrong, yeah.
Yeah, but on the whole, I can honestly say I was truly entertained and I absolutely loved it. Well done.
Let's go to you, Freddie. What do you think from the sporting perspective?
Watching it, you got a sense of this team aspect, because if you're chucking people up in the air, you've got to have a massive amount of trust that the person underneath is going to catch you. And that really came across. Just to Ben, you know, I played cricket, mm-hmm. and the place where I grew up, nobody liked cricket. and I got a lot of stick from other people. I had to do different sports. Is that something that you've had to tackle?
Yeah, where we're from, I get a lot of stick all the time.
Mate, but... I reckon you're having the last laugh there, son, aren't you? Yeah.
All right, Rio, what do you think?
I can really associate with Ben and with myself. Not many people know this, but I used to do ballet as a kid. And
do you think you made the right choice?
Probably. Sometimes a little bit daunting when you got your rucksack on or your bag and you're going off to training and stuff and people are asking you where you're going. And at times back in the past, I used to maybe say, I was going football. But then in the end, I got a bit of confidence and said, listen, I don't care. I'm going to go ballet. I'm going dancing. What are you going to say about that? I'm flexible. It helped me in my future game, which became obviously football. And your wife
really liked it.
Can I just ask, Rio, did you do good tours, bad tours when you were at ballet?
Pirouettes.
I'd love to see that.
Come on. Hey, Freddie, come on,
come on.
Here you go. There you go. All right, come on, Freddie.
I don't even remember how to do it. Hold on.
Come on,
put your fingers on that one.
Come on. All right, what are we doing, Rio?
If I remember rightly, I think it was. I'm going to get mulled for this.
Yeah, come on.
Come on. So, you put your foot out like that, there, down, and.
Foot down.
Yeah. Excellent. That's what Freddie's wife makes him do every time he comes home from the pub. I've not had a drink. All right, so well done, Sussex Tornadoes. You did a great performance, got some good comments from our judges. But will they give you gold, silver, or bronze? Let's find out what they're going to give you. Two silvers! Well done! Well done! The Sussex Tornado!
The hardest move, obviously, was our power move. We didn't land it correctly, but hopefully it won't go against us. We did the double back tuck. She'd done the really hard skill. It was just the landing.
So all five teams have performed, but only one of them can win a place in this Saturday's final. And that decision is in the hands of our audience. The vote's next. Don't miss it. Welcome back to Let's Get Gold. It's been quite a night, I think you'll agree. We've seen some unique and fantastic performances, and our judges have had their say. It was informed, it was interesting, but ultimately, counts for naught, because it's now up to our studio audience here to decide who will win a place in this Saturday's final. Will it be Air Gravity? Cooksoul 1? The Street Team? The Golden Oldies? Or the Sussex Tornadoes? It's a big decision. Studio audience, please vote now. Job done. The votes are being counted and verified, and the result will be with us very, very soon. In the meantime, here's why our teams think they should win tonight.
I think we deserve a place in the final, and hopefully we've done enough.
We put in gimmicks, we've got the Michael Jackson in there, we've got the Superman in there, the Matrix. We just kind of really wanted to bring something different to the table.
We really, really want to hear our names called to be in the final on Saturday, purely because we've worked so hard to get this far, and we've got loads more to give.
If we get through to the final, it means that's closer to that £100,000. It'd just be amazing.
I would like to disappoint the youngsters. It would be great for us to give them a run for their money. Definitely.
I think we've shown everyone that we're the act to beat at the moment. We've worked 9 till 5, 7 days a week for the last 8 weeks. We've put in so much work. So 100% we deserve to be in the final.
Air Gravity were absolutely amazing, but at the end of the day, they were doing one element, bouncing a trampoline, where we tried to bring in so many different things. I just hope that the audience appreciate that.
We've all worked so hard to get to where we are, and it would be a great pat on the back to actually get through.
Well, they all want to win, but before we announce the results, let's put our judges on the spot and ask them which team struck gold tonight. Rio, on behalf of the sport judges, who do you guys think deserves to win tonight?
Well, they've made it difficult for us because it was all fantastic, but I think the fact that this is fresh, it's new to our eyes, the technical difficulty in it was huge. We went for air gravity. Air gravity.
Martine!
We think that the team that kind of captured the essence of what this show is all about was the street team.
Thank you very much, judges. The time for speculation is over. The result is in. Let's get gold. Air gravity. Cook Soul 1. The street team. Golden Oldies. And the Sussex Tornadoes. The team that will be competing again this Saturday in the final for a chance to be crowned Let's Get Gold champions and win that incredible £100,000 for their sport and their club is... Air Gravity! Come on in, come on in. Congratulations, Air Gravity. How do you feel?
Amazing, amazing. I thought the street team had it. I can't believe we won. Brilliant.
I think you'll agree, everyone tonight put in some sterling performances. And let's just say congratulations to the Air Gravity team, but also commiserations to the rest of our competitors tonight. You've been absolutely awesome.
The standard from everybody else was so high. When we were watching backstage, we were thinking, man, this is going to be tough. We just hope we've done enough, but... And thankfully we did, but everyone else was fantastic on the night, so well done.
Well, you're now one step closer to £100,000. Obviously, you're going to be competing in Saturday's final. A well-deserved victory for Air Gravity. Big thanks to all of our teams and our judges, of course. That's it for tonight. We'll be back again tomorrow evening at 9, right here on ITV1, when five more cracking teams will be turning their sports into showbiz spectacles as they compete to line up alongside Air Gravity. Yeah. Saturday's grand final. We'll see you tomorrow night. God bless. Good night.
Tomorrow, five more teams take their sport.